Thank you, Rufford Foundation, for providing grants for nature conservation.
This is the fifth conference, the fourth for East Africa, the fifth for actually Ghana. This is a good job that is being done by Rufford, the workshop organizer here, Mr. Karenzi. And I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you, Mr. Alphonse Karenzi, who is the workshop organizer, to just give us an introductory speech and then we'll proceed.
My name is Karenzi Alphonse. I'm also a Rufford Small Grant recipient. I've received all my 5 Rufford grants. I'm one of the organizers because there are many people who helped me to make this conference a success. And I'll just say a few words, then I'll welcome a few of them. I'll recognize them. They'll come here and say hi to you. It is good that most of us are Rufford recipients, so we know what Rufford is. But for those who are not recipients or who are interested in applying, I'll tell you Rufford Foundation is a very amazing organization. It doesn't only do funding, but it also invests in connection between us. That's why you see conferences. We organize conferences in different countries, as he said, of organizing the conferences, but I want to assure you it is a great opportunity to connect with people. I remember the first conference I organized and attended was in Rwanda, but I got some amazing contacts that helped me to expand my work. Now my organization is in Burundi and Uganda through the conference, through the contacts I got from the conference. I attended a conference in Ghana, then I got an accident, but the Rufford recipients showed me the love that my family had never showed me. And I realized that Rufford is now a global family for us. Every country you go in, there is a Rufford recipient. Feel free to connect with them. There will be a good contact for you. The Rufford Conference. So these conferences are an opportunity for us to know each other, to connect, to share ideas, experiences, and learn from each other.
Each presentation will take 10 minutes, and then we'll have a session for questions.
My name's David Milera. I'm a Rufford recipient also. I've received my 2 grants. I work for Kenya Marine and Fisheries Research Institute, based in Mombasa, and I'm happy to be here together with you.
So let's begin. I will talk to you about the resilience of Kenyan forests to human pressure. Next, please.
No-take zones, meaning they are supposed to preserve some areas, the breeding and nursery areas, where they are not supposed to go and fish for some, so that it gives time for the young fish to regenerate.
Yes, Nancy, can we clap? Good.
That is the background behind one of the Kenya's goal, national government of eradicating rabies by 2030. And what we are doing right now is just working with the Kenyan government to ensure that we can hit this goal together. Now, how do we do it?
Background is on conservation. And so it was funded by the Rufford Foundation. In Serengeti or in many protected areas across the world, poaching is a problem, and this is one of the threats that is actually causing species decline.
It's all about the community and how we are protecting our conservancy. Now, my project it's about mature mangrove forest regeneration, integrated approach to restore mangrove habitat. It was funded by Rufford Small Grant, and that was in July 2017.
So I'd like to present on one of our programs. In 2017, we were supported by the Rufford Small Grants Foundation to support our warriors, our Gravity River Trust warriors, to transition from written data sheets to smart data collection. And that's what I'd like to highlight today.
Until you dig a hole, plant a tree,
water it, and ensure that it grows, you've not done a thing. So I believe the Rufford Foundation, myself, and others who are supporting the project are at least doing something.
Yeah. Now, I hope we have written the questions that we need to ask Christopher. We'll have all
cultural practices. How do you ensure that the tree seedlings you are going to give to the community will happily embrace them and they will not have negative perceptions about it?
I noted that in your presentation you said you walked for between 9 and 20 kilometers when you are doing your research. Now, my inquiry is there a way we can use modern technology, for instance, the development of the AI technology?
Why do you think that carnivorous species are very important? You said you train the communities in terms of using the cyber truck and the smart, eh? I don't know, do you specify the kind of smartphone to use?
Ukikata muti moja, panda miti tano, wacha kuharibu, ardhi kesho taita. Nikisema hivyo, sio kwa ubaya, na kuonya ndugu tulinde dunia yetu. Before the Lord created man, he created. To conserve, dress it, and take care of it. With the Rufford Foundation, we're urging you, people. To watch over.
I want to recognize the second runner-up that is about 3 years old by the presentations. And that person. No, stop panicking. Okay. That person is none other than Sheila. Okay, Dedan Gatia.
He gave his responsibility to conserve, dress it, and take care of it. With the Rufford Foundation, we're urging you.